Also in the news today, a survey of workplaces has found that 1 in 10 harbour a worker with psychopathic tendencies, creating toxic workspaces and making colleagues ill. This is absolutely true. We're joined by Dr. Janet Hall, who has encountered many corporate psychopaths in her time. Welcome, Janet. Welcome.
Corporate psychopath. So that's not like the stabby-stabby psychopath. It's like a different...
Well, the stabby-stabby psychopath is actually breaking the law criminally and obviously physically, whereas the corporate psychopath is a psychological and emotional bully.
So, manipulative.
So how do you know if the person in the cubicle next to you is a psychopath?
Well, you'd have been watching his behaviour or her behaviour, and they have no sense of social conscience. They're not remorseful for any bad thing that they do. They have no empathy for anybody else and no compassion.
Well, I'm sitting next to you right now. What do you reckon? Seriously, though, do you think I could possibly be one of these psychos? We've met before.
Oh, Dave, I think you've got a heart of gold, no matter what else is going on down in there.
Really? Well, I have conned you.
Are the psychopaths attracted to any specific industry?
I found that they tend to be in the advertising industry.
I read in the article, the description was, it's an inflated sense of self-worth, pathological lie, manipulative behaviour and lack of remorse. Real estate? Am I thinking real estate? Or is it just me?
Could be car salesmen.
Could
be the entertainment industry.
No,
there's a number of them around here, absolutely.
Yeah. Is it true, though, that these type of people tend to actually get ahead in the workplace?
Yes, they do. They're ruthless, they're risk-takers, they manipulate and charm. They know how to suck up to their superiors. If they don't need anybody who's their perceived inferior, they walk all over the top of those. And they're always covering their own back because it's always about them.
There's some uncomfortable psychopaths shifting around in their chairs at home.
Right, you could be a psychopath a little bit of the time, like a part-time psychopath. Sometimes I work with people and I think they really should be dictators, you know, ruling countries and, you know, possibly causing genocide. Then other days I think, nah, you're really nice.
Well, that's how good they are. But there's a difference between using people and abusing people. So the psychopath is abusing people.
Now, I'm sure I've worked with one of these people, I once had a job where I would drive into work every day and I would sit in the car park for 15 minutes in my car just building up the strength to take them on for the day. And after a while, I got so bad, I thought, I can't do this anymore. So I just started riding my bike to work. Now, that just meant I had longer to build up my strength. But what can someone do about it? How can someone overcome this if they've got one of these people in the workplace?
I'm voting Charlie for psychopath.
First of all, there's a big don't. And the don't is don't ever set yourself up one-to-one against this person because they are so good, they will totally demoralise you and leave you feel like you're the one who's causing the trouble. So what you need to do is be very, very careful about getting other people enrolled, keeping records, and then when you pounce, you've got just, you know, the invincible evidence that they've got to go.
Dr. Janet Hall, thank you very much for joining us tonight.